My name is Seemant. I'm the Center Head for DataTrained Noida Campus. So today we will be speaking about how to become a data scientist. We will also be speaking about what is data science actually in the most basic level. So we are waiting for people to join. Just bear with me for some time. So we all know that data science is one of the sexiest jobs nowadays, and they pay very well. So we will be going through every bit about it. We just have to wait for some time. Satish, Mr. Satish has joined us. Hi, Satish. Soon other people will also join us. Then we will be taking this further. Meanwhile, if you have any queries, you can ask me. You can write in the comment section whatever questions you may have. And soon we will be taking forward this session. So we will be discussing about what are the most basic skills a data scientist must have. Okay. And we will be speaking about what is data science, basically. Though it is a very, generic term, and some people use data analytics and data science interchangeably, but actually both these terms are unique. But they are interrelated. So we will be going into that. Mr. Janardhan has also joined us. Hi, Janardhan. Mr. Pranav has also joined us. Hi, Pranav. Mr. Sadaf Khan also joined us. Hi, Sadaf. So you can ask your queries also. We will be starting very soon. Most of you may already know a bit about data science. It's a science that deals with data. So like whatever we can know from the data, because if we talk about science, it's a Latin word basically. So it means knowledge, to know. And data, we all know what is data. Everything is data nowadays. So facts and statistics collected for reference or analysis, right? That is data. So the science that deals with data, that is data science. In a layman's language, if we talk about. So some people have joined. We are waiting for others to join. Just bear with me for some time. Mr. Atif has also joined us. Hi, Atif. It's a very nice morning today. For last couple of days, raining has been there. But today, the weather is quite good. So we have 5 people have joined with us. And we have Asma Khan also with us. So Asma is asking a question. May I please know about DataTrained? So DataTrained is an analytics company. We were started in 2012. And Mr. Jatin Juneja started this organization. He has experience of more than 22 years. He has worked with major corporates. And basically the focus of DataTrained is to bridge the gap between the industry and academia. So in fact, we have started other professional courses also, though our core competency is analytics, data science. We have our own visualization tool also that won an award also. We call it DULU, D-U-L-U. If you have other queries, you can ask me. And for more information, you can go to our website also. So as I said, basically we are, so Navesh has also joined us. I'm good, Navesh, how are you doing? So as I was saying that the main focus of DataTrained is to bridge the gap between the industry and academia. So we are totally committed to get these students their dream job. And being an analytics company, we have that much penetration in the market. In fact, we are the only educational institute in Asia that is offering guaranteed placement or money back guarantee. Sia Sharma has also joined us. I am good, Sia. How are you doing? So I think we have We have many people now. Many people have joined. We can start with our session. So the topic of today's session is how to become a data scientist. But before that, let's understand what is data science. So data science refers to the processes and methods that help us make sense of large volume of data for organizational purpose. Now the organization may be a very big organization, let's say a FMCG, giant like Hindustan Unilever or Procter & Gamble, or the organization can be a very small organization, let's say a startup, because data science is used in every industry today. Yeah, so as Saurabh is asking us, what is the scope of data science in India? As I said, as per the Economic Times, there is 400% rise in the demand for data science professionals. There are many roles in data science. There are data analysts also, there are data engineers also, there are data visualization experts, there are business analysts, there are statisticians, and of course, there's data scientist who deals with more, complex aspect of data science, who is more, focused towards finding the pattern and asking the relevant questions from the business, from the management. So Sajid has also joined us. Hi, Sajid, how are you? So as I said, data science is the science that deals with data. And the scope of data science is huge, not just in India, in fact, across the world. So the job of data scientist is to, use this science to achieve the stated objective or to solve a problem, business problem. Major business problems are solved using data science today. Basically, there are 8 steps to go about it. The very first step is to understand the business, right? So what does the company do? Which industry is it into? What is that the organization wants to achieve? So the second step is to set the goals. What is that the organization wants to achieve? Do the organization want to increase the profit? Or, whatever is the agenda. So the second step is to set the goal. Then the third step is to collect the data, right? Most of the times, this data is given in unstructured format. So we have to clean that data also. So the fourth step is cleaning of the data and exploring the data. Then the next step is modeling the data, connecting the data with the stated problem. The second step, the goals we set in the beginning. So how our data is linked with that goal. So that is the fifth step, model data. Then there comes the sixth step, which is the present findings. What are the findings we have recovered through using the data visualization tools? And then we make the decisions. What is the insight basically? Should we increase the marketing expenses because the data shows, the past data shows that by increasing the marketing expense, the profit will go on the higher side, or, it is not working, we should decrease it. So whatever is the decisions that we take, we make decisions in the seventh step. Then in the last step, we refine the findings. We again collect the data. We check whether, it suits our, findings. Because data is also changing. Again, we need to collect the data. Again, we need to explore it, clean it. Again, we need to model it. Again, we need to present the findings. So that's a never-ending process, right? So that's how to go about it. Now let's move on to the important part, which is how to become a data scientist. Now, there are basically 6 skills that a data scientist must possess, right? The first skill and the most important skill is statistics, because statistics is the core of data science. As we all know, statistics is a very broad field that deals with collection, analysis, interpretation, presentation, and organization of data, right? So because data is all about numbers, so statistics is the basic of data science. So statistics is the very first skill that one needs to have. Right. Then the second skill that is very crucial to become a data scientist is programming language. In fact, first we need to learn the programming language. I mean, it is advised, because once you know the programming language, then you can use the statistics principles easily, right? So statistic principles are used in every every tool we use, that because that is the core of data science. So when it comes to programming language, it is with the help of programming languages that one can design tools for data analysis. So there are many languages, but Python and R are the two widely used languages that data scientists use today. So at least one of these two languages, one must have a good command over, right, in order to become a data scientist. So for that, we need to, practice also. Though it is not very difficult, because if we talk about Python, the syntaxes are quite easy. It's not very difficult, right? These syntaxes are easy to, memorize, easy to, learn. So, and so programming languages is the second most important aspect of becoming a data scientist. So, but it is not necessary that one must be from a technical background or one must be BTech, because these things can be learned very easily. And it's more about the practice. Then the next thing is, the next most important skill a data scientist must have is machine learning. Machine learning, as the name suggests, it's the ability of a computer to, learn from a data set without, programming it, right? So basically it comes under AI. So we can say that all machine learnings are artificial intelligence, but not all artificial intelligence is machine learning. So there is difference. Then there are different parts in machine learning also. There is deep learning also. There is supervised machine learning. There is unsupervised machine learning. So that is also one of the very important aspects of becoming a data scientist. Then the another skill that one needs to have is big data technologies, because it is very much obvious a data scientist need to have some sense of big data technologies to make use of big data. So Hadoop and Spark are the two big data technologies that data scientists use widely. Okay, so but these are also not very difficult. And Hadoop, if we talk about Hadoop, it is very much easy. It can be Spark is also it is very compatible with SQL also. That is the structured query language. So that is big data technologies, right? Then the next aspect of becoming a data scientist, the skill that one need to have is data visualization tools, because we need to present our findings, right? We being a technical person, we may know what the data is saying, but the management or a layman does not understand. So we need to explain to the business owner what data is saying. So for that, data visualization tools are used. So we must have knowledge about these tools also. Tableau is one of the most popular visualization tools in data science circles. There are others also, like ClickView and Microsoft's Power BI. So these tools are also important to enhance our data scientist's ability to explain key findings simply. Okay. Now, the next skill that one needs to have is business acumen. So it's not just about being technical. A data scientist must have business acumen also. A data scientist, because as I said, the very first step of solving a organization's problem or achieving the goal is to understand the business. A data scientist must know what the company is doing, what is the business, what they are into, right? So knowing the different aspects of the business, the marketing department they need to talk to, they should understand all the operations also, and the communication part also plays a very important role, right? So it's not just that if somebody is technically strong but soft skills are not there, so he can become a data scientist. No, soft skills are also very important to become a data scientist, because in a meeting or you know, when you are presenting your findings, you need to convince the management, you need to convince the colleagues about your findings, about the decisions you are proposing, right? So communication is also very important aspect. So as I said, business acumen. So there are other aspects also in this. One needs to you know, learn with time, and you know, about the industry, about the business, and so it's a never-ending process. So that these skills are very much important to become a data scientist. Then if you're, then it depends on your you know, level also, what level you are right now at. If you are an experienced person, let's say you are a software developer, then it would be a bit easy for you, because let's say you know Python already, right? So in that case, you can simply you know, go to the projects. You can start you know, working on the projects. So it would be easy for you. But if you don't know the languages, though you have a mathematical background, then you will have to put in efforts. So the very first step should be to decide on the role. What is the role you are taking? Because as I said, there are different roles in data science industry. There are statisticians also, there are data analysts, there are business analysts, you know, there are data analysts and business analyst managers also. So we need to decide which role we want to opt for. And some roles are better for a particular person. For example, let's say you are a software engineer, you are a software developer, then becoming a data engineer would be easy for you. Or I would say it's more you know, logical to join that role, right? The next step should be to understand that role completely. What does that role ask for? And not just that, for that we need to go for a training also. We need to enhance our skill. So we may go for the you know, different resources, learning resources available online, or we can go through a book, we can join a course. It's not about a free course or a paid course. It's more about learning the you know, technology, learning the gist. It's more about understanding how the particular technology is used in real life, right? So because it doesn't matter which institute, educational institute you join, or how much fees you are paying. It's more about your own skills and, you know, your own attitude towards learning. If somebody likes learning, if somebody loves learning, then definitely one can become a data scientist, right? Then the networking part is also important. But you don't need to waste a lot of time in networking also. That is the later part. First of all, you need to work on your basic skills, these six skills that I talked about. So your statistics should be strong. You should know the machine learning by heart. You should be very good with programming. You should know, you should have the sense of the big data technologies. And you know, business acumen is also important. Data visualization tools are important. So first you need to work upon your skills. Soft skills also and technical skills also, right? After that, you can, you know, join a community and mark your presence in the community. There can be a lot of things you can learn from the renowned data scientists. They keep posting about, you know, their discoveries about the industry and everything. So these, so from them, you can learn a lot of things, right? So that's how you become a data scientist. If you have any queries, you can ask me. I'm here to answer your queries. So as Saurabh Chauhan asked, what is the scope of data science in India? It's huge, not just in India, around the world, because data science is something that the applications of data science can be found in every industry, every aspect. Starting from the scientific organization, big organizations like NASA, to the small organization, let's say a startup. Everybody is using data, because today it is an era when everything is data and data is everything, right? So the scope is like never before. We have already you know, talked about it, and we have seen in articles and everything also how big the scope is. So I don't need to go much into that. but it's more about, you know, our own skills and aptitude, because data science is still at a very beginning, you know, at a very beginner's level. Though the origin is very, you know, it was started in the digital evolution era, but still, most of the people does not know the difference between a data analyst and data scientist, right? So, it's more about our own skill. We need to, you know, be very good with the technologies. We need to update ourselves with the, you know, upcoming technologies. So, and, you know, it's more about learning, basically. So the scope is not a problem if we are willing to put in that much of efforts, right? So if you have any queries, you can ask. I'm here. So about DataTrained, I have already told you, we are a very old company. We were started in 2012. And we are very much committed to get you your dream job. And we have started other courses also. We have started courses in retail banking also now, and in digital marketing also. Though being an analytics company, we are more into data science. But we have started other professional courses also. So depending on the strength of the student and, you know, what is their interest area, we suggest which professional course they should opt for. So Asma Khan asked, what are the area we need to focus during the course? So as I said, we need to have these six skills. So we need to focus on all these six areas. And the area where you think you are not very good, for example, if somebody does not come from a programming language background, then that person should focus on that aspect very well. And it's more about getting the concept rather than, you know, going through the theory or, you know. So if somebody does not understand anything, because we, our trainers, our mentors take everything from the scratch. If you are good at something, then there's no issue. Then there's no point in wasting the time over that particular topic or, you know, that particular area. But if you are not good at something, then our trainers, our mentors would take it from the scratch. Now it's up to you. If you don't understand something, whether you are asking questions or you're not asking questions, because most of the time a student does not get success in the area is because the student does not ask questions. Right. So all the areas we need to consider, we just need to be focused on learning, that we should get the concept of everything. So Radhika has asked, she's a BTech graduate and she has got 2 years of experience as a developer. So is data science good, ideal for Radhika? Definitely. You are from a mathematical background and you have experience as a developer, definitely data science is for you. In fact, you know, technologies are changing. So it depends like which language you are working with, C++, or because these technologies are quite old now. So we need to learn Python, R. These are the programming languages widely used. So data science is very much ideal for you because you already have that background, that mathematical background, right? So in fact, this data science course is mostly for BTech or MCA guys, right? Or at least, I mean, mathematical background one should have, right? So what are the steps to join DataTrained course? So Sia has asked one question, what are the steps to join DataTrained course? So basically the first step is to give one online assessment. You need to clear that online assessment. Then we would be sending you first some printed material and some recorded lectures so that you can have a rough idea about the basics of data science. Then your actual batch will start. You would be provided a dedicated mentor from the industry that you choose. The mentor's job will be to grow you into a full-fledged data scientist, right? So, but the first step is to give the online assessment. Because there's no point if you are afraid of maths or statistics, If you are, afraid of numbers, then data science is not for you. Then we would be suggesting you, other professional courses based on your expertise. Let's say you're good with people, or let's say you are good with, customer service. Then we would suggest you go for the banking course, right? So it all depends on your caliber and your strength and weakness. So you must do your SWOT analysis first. You should know your strengths. You should know your weaknesses. You should know the opportunities that are present in the industry you want to join, or the industries that are there as opportunities, depending on your strength, basically. Right. And obviously, you should know your weakness also so that you can overcome your weakness. And threats, I don't think there's any threat. Threat can be your own weakness, nothing else. Right. So, Atif has asked, I'm into banking. Can I get into data science? Yes, definitely. In banking, data science is very much used, to check whether, to check the risk, appetite of a customer, and, whether one should give loans to, this age group or not. There are many problems in banking industry, as we all know already, right? So definitely you can go into banking. If you're into banking, you can go into data science. Data science is used in every industry nowadays, right? So Pranav has asked, someone who don't have technical knowledge, is he or she eligible for the data science role? Well, it depends what kind of technical knowledge you are, talking about, right? So let's say you are not BTech, or you are a simple, science graduate with mathematics or statistics. Then yes, you can join data science industry, right? Because other things can be taught to you, but IQ is something which is, which is already there with you. So you must have a fair enough IQ. I'm not saying you should be brilliant, but yeah, you should have a fair enough IQ to join this industry, because every person is different. Not everybody is made for, data science industry. Some people are good with some other aspects, right? So, if you are good with numbers, then you can join data science. You must have you should know about the, basic 10th class mathematics, and you should be good at it. Good in the sense that you should be logical, right? So, Abhinav, what are your past placement records? Well, if I talk about the last batch, the maximum package was around 19 lakhs. And on an average, the package was 6 to 7 lakhs, I think. Yeah. So, and we could place all of our students. We gave 100% placement for the. That is our core competency. As I said, we are very much committed to get you your dream job, right? So, placement records are perfect. You can check our website. You can check our blogs also. So, and minimum package, I think, was 5.2 lakhs. Yeah, 5.2 lakhs was the minimum package offered in the last batch, right? So, any other questions, if you may have, you can ask me. Right. So, as I said, basically, we should, and it is not just for data science, for any industry, any professional. We should do our SWOT analysis, let's say every month or every 3-4 months. In every 3-4 months, we should review what were our weaknesses, could we overcome our weaknesses, right? What are our strengths? There are, we talk to students, and there are some students who doesn't know their strengths at all. So that should not be the case. One should know, we should know our strengths. And based on our strengths, we should choose which career, which industry we should choose, how to go about it, right? Because knowing our strengths is very much, crucial to a, good career. Because that's what gives us a direction, right? So, and strength, weakness are mostly these things are, though organizations also use SWOT analysis. But I think for an individual, opportunities are, everywhere. Especially if we talk about India, opportunities are everywhere. And threat, I don't think any threat is there except our own weaknesses. So we should do that. We should know our strengths. We should work upon our weaknesses time to time. And then placement and job is not an issue, right? In fact, getting a job is easy, but growing in the job and, you know, sometimes the job security itself, that all depends on our performance, how we perform. So we are offering 100% placement guarantee, but we do not have any magic wand that we will wave and you will become a data scientist. We can, you know, give you all the knowledge, all the guidance or the direction we can give you, but you yourself has to, you know, get yourself ready for the industry. You yourself has to, you know, work upon your weaknesses. So if somebody is new to programming language, then the person must give at least 2-3 hours every day for practice and everything, right? So Sadaf Khan has asked us, what is the difference between online and offline course? Well, there's no difference actually. Both are same. In fact, online is going to be the future of education now. We have seen Byju's and other you know, players in the market who are catering to school students for online teaching. So there's not much difference. In online course also, you the student will be interacting with the mentor or the trainer live. So live sessions will be there. So everything can be asked. But yes, that personal touch or that physical presence of a trainer, that has some different, you know. So that's why we have started the offline course also now. But that is in Noida location only as of now. In future, we may, you know, take that to other cities also. So basically, there's not much difference in between online and offline. Both the courses have equivalent, you know, impact on your abilities if you are willing to give that much attention, that much efforts. If you're ready to put in, there's not much difference in both the cases. So Asma has asked, where are you located? So DataTrained is headquartered in Bengaluru. We have office in Noida and New York also. We have just started in Noida now. So I'm from Noida branch. Basically, I'm taking care of the Noida campus in DataTrained. So any other queries, anybody can ask me. Or we can end the session, right? So it was nice talking to all of you. It was nice being with you all, guys. I hope I answered your questions correctly. Thank you so much. You all have a nice time. Bye-bye.